Welcome to Barbell Business. I'm Mike Bledsoe here with Doug Larson and Markus Gerszi. And today we're going to be talking about the Barbell Mastermind. You may have seen us post a lot of things on Instagram, Facebook. Oh, yeah. You've heard us talk about it before, and we really want to dive into exactly what it is so you can find out if it's something you actually want to participate in or just watch via Instagram.
Yeah, a lot of people do masterminds. We've been to many masterminds ourselves, which is how we kind of got into running our own masterminds, which is what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about our specific masterminds called the Barbell Mastermind. But a lot of people don't know what a mastermind is and how it's different from seminars, workshops, conferences, and all these other live events or networking events. So, you know, in your mind, how is a mastermind, and then we'll get into our mastermind, but how is just the concept of having a mastermind different than like a workshop or a seminar or like a big conference?
Yeah, so a mastermind is more of a structured discussion. There's a theme throughout the entire mastermind. Everyone's there that is, it attracts like-minded people because we are all interested in the same thing. And so, you know, a mastermind might not even need to be about business specifically, but it tends to be. And so, and business is such a big niche. Like one of the first masterminds I ever attended, Doug and I both went, was it attracted a lot of people who were in internet marketing. And we weren't necessarily only internet marketers or anything like that, but we went there with that common theme of everyone understands these core principles and has a certain, I guess, certain understanding and foundation that's similar, and then we can all have a conversation that's the same. Mm-hmm. And the mastermind is more of a structured discussion throughout the week. You know, there might be some speakers here and there, but it's not about sitting in a classroom and taking notes all day. Like, you know, a course or a workshop or a seminar might be. It's more about interacting, and networking is a huge piece of what's going on at these things.
Yeah, most workshops and seminars, they're more about someone who's really knowledgeable, who's a true expert sitting on, or standing rather, on stage and kind of telling the audience what they need to know and how to do whatever it is they're trying to do, whether it's programming or whether it's, you know, business advice, it's marketing or what have you. You know, someone's really good and they're basically just teaching the audience. You're sitting in class, you're taking notes, and you're not really interacting with the rest of the crowd because everyone's there for that one guru, so to speak, to tell them how to do whatever it is they're trying to do. Yeah. Masterminds are not like that. Everyone at a mastermind is an expert in a very specific field, whether it's, you know, the fitness industry, and you can have a, you know, a bunch of coaches that are all A players and they're all just sharing advice and best practices on how to be a better coach. Or again, you could be, you know, an internet marketer, or you could be, you know, you could be a tennis player. It doesn't really matter. Just a mastermind, the whole concept is getting a bunch of experts together to discuss what they do and to share ideas with each other.
Yeah, usually someone who comes in a mastermind is there to teach as much as they are to learn. Mm-hmm. You know, what we don't want is people coming to a mastermind who are there just to sit quietly in the corner and take notes the whole time and just consume. Mm-hmm. There's a very interactive thing. There's an expectation that everybody in the room is there to teach everybody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the distinction between the workshop seminar versus the mastermind, where you go to learn some tactical stuff at a workshop. Like, hey, I want to learn how to, you know, improve my intake system or how to run better ads. That's a workshop. The mastermind, you're coming to contribute and become a better leader, a better entrepreneur, whatever it is that you're doing. It's about kind of evolving together with other people who are, you know, like-minded and just working their ass off to make an impact together. We're all bringing our strengths together. We're exposing our weaknesses, because my weakness could be your strength and something that you're like, dude, I crushed that last year. Mm-hmm. Let me help you with this. So it's way more about it just, I think, evolving and progressing as a person, as a business owner, regardless really of kind of what your niche is in our market.
Yeah, I remember the first mastermind that Doug and I went to, it was, I wouldn't say we pushed our way in, but it was like, it's like we wanted to go to the mastermind. We're like, this is a next level thing to do. You don't, you know, we had done the workshops, we had done the conferences, we had done a lot of things to learn about business. We had watched, you know, tons of videos, listened to podcasts about business. And we were, we knew that the mastermind was another level to go. And I remember showing up and being really nervous because I knew that contribution was a huge piece of what the mastermind is supposed to be. And I talked to a lot of people, and I come to find out almost every single person is nervous their first mastermind. Mm-hmm. Because when you do walk in the room, it is people who already know what they're talking about. Mm-hmm. And it was really cool for us because we were actually able to teach a lot of things at that mastermind, even though, you know, the night before it started, I was like, I'm not going to be able to teach anybody anything. But it ended up being a lot of fun, and connecting with people and being able to teach and give and take was a really cool experience.
Yeah, it's kind of like going to regionals. Like, if it's your first time going to regionals, you're like, oh man, like, do I belong here? Like,
yeah.
And then unless you just know that you're so far ahead of everyone else for some crazy reason and you just have never decided to sign up for regionals before, like, you probably worked your ass off to get there. And by the time you got there, you're like, man, like, I know that guy's famous. That guy's famous. That guy's a fucking killer. That guy's a killer. That's how it was at that first mastermind I went to. I was like, I know that dude. This guy did this other really incredible thing. That guy made $1 million in a day one time. We're in the room with these like crazy A players, and I'm like, man, do we belong here? And then once we sat down and started having conversations, it became very apparent that, you know, these people were very good at a few aspects of business, and they're very well known for those aspects of business. But like everyone else, they have some holes in their game, and yep. I'm really good at some things. I got holes in my game, and that's the whole thing. Like, we're all really good at something, and we're able to share those ideas. Like, if you go to regionals, you know, maybe you can clean and jerk 350, and so your clean and jerk's really, really good. But, you know, maybe someone else, they're at regionals because they can run 4.5 minute miles, and they're really good on the kind of the other side of the spectrum, so to speak.
Right,
so
right.
You have things that you can teach each other. You're not going to be the best at every single thing when you go to regionals, typically. Like, there's going to be some variance in your abilities.
Yeah, no
doubt. It's just like that when you go to mastermind. You're good at something. The other people are good at something else, and you can help each other by trading your ideas. And, you know, if you're not as good at, you know, at building a team, and I happen to be really, really good at culture or whatever, like, we can share our different ideas around those different topics. We can help each other.
Totally.
Yeah. I think for people coming to their first mastermind retreat too, it's often discovery of what that thing is. Clearly, if you've achieved a pretty decent level of success, and maybe you don't realize yet, you're like, man, like, I'm the culture thing is like totally my jam. But when you're in these environments, it gets drawn out of you, and you're like, oh, I totally know what you're struggling with. And all of a sudden, you see people discover, or I think really kind of tune into what that like superpower is that they have.
That is true. I mean, that kind of like what when I was talking about our first mastermind we attended, I was like, I don't know what I can offer. By the end of the first day, I was like, oh, I know exactly what we're best at.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're best at, you know, putting together podcasts and providing value to people right out the gate. Like, as soon as they show up, they learn something and that is useful for them to improve their lives. And a lot of people that were in the room with us, they didn't really know how to do that well yet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, so after we attended our first couple of masterminds, and we had done Barbell Shrugged for a number of years and Barbell Business for a number of years, like, having done the show for so long, we're very fortunate that we have an insane network of people that we know. We know tons of experts in the world of fitness.
Yeah.
We know tons of experts in the world of business. We just have a very big network, and we happen to be very, very lucky. And so we thought, like, why are we only attending masterminds? Like, we totally should be hosting masterminds since we know so many people in the industry, and all those people don't necessarily know each other. Like, we could host an event and introduce all of our friends to each other and just do it mastermind style, where it's not just hosting a seminar or a workshop where, like, we're on stage and everyone's in the audience looking at us. We're just all getting together. We're facilitating conversations around business, personal growth, you know, sales and marketing, around, you know, building a team, you know, improving the culture of the business or the gym, depending on if you're a business owner a gym owner or just a fitness industry CEO or what have you. And that was a very unique position for us to be in because we have such a large network. And that's part of the reason that, in my opinion, that why the masterminds have worked so well for us is because we know so many people and we can bring them all together and then we can just hang out for a couple of days and everyone can leave having made friends.
Yeah.
With the other A players in the industry, which is really the goal of the mastermind. It's a networking event where you can walk away with a real first name basis with other people who are fucking absolute killers in the industry, and then you can play the long game by being friends with those people for years or decades. You know, maybe you learn some sales marketing tactics and whatever, and you get a few members in your gym and you grow, and that's cool too. But, you know, the mastermind is really where you can meet people that, you know, they are serious A players, and you might be able to, you know, bring them on as a business partner 5 years from now, 10 years from now. Like, you're trying to make real friendships, and that really is the goal.
Yeah, and I would also point out that basically everything that we do, it's not simply because the opportunity exists. We bring things like, you know, Barbell Logic, the things we've done with Barbell Shrugged, and now the Barbell Mastermind. We bring these things out because we see a gap in the market. Somebody else isn't doing it. Or we see somebody doing it and it's not as good as we think it could be done. And, you know, we don't do anything that we don't think we can be the best at. And so we have attended many different masterminds that are not in the fitness industry. They're in different industries overall, including the fitness industry. I've been to those as well. And I want to put something together that is it doesn't exist and there's nothing else like it, and there's and we can do it better than anybody else. So if you're listening to this and you're in our marketplace in this functional fitness space, I really believe what we do at our mastermind is the top tier.
So what can someone expect when they come to one of these masterminds? Because I remember when I first attended my first Barbell Mastermind, I was totally blown away with what I was experienced. I showed up to this like crazy mansion in San Diego out in, I don't even know how many acres that was. It was like a 100-acre lot in the hills of San Diego.
We had like a whole ranch. So,
straight up, like a whole like was enough for, compound.
Enough for Brian McKenzie to get up in the morning, and he took his mountain bike out, and he comes back, and he's like, dude, these guys chased me off their property with guns. Like he had gone to the next ranch over, and it was just like, and then he discovered like tons of marijuana plants, and these guys like chasing him off the property. He's like, I've been in the wrong place.
I should probably leave now, fast.
We're not using that house again.
Yeah, so I show up to this property, and it's in the middle of nowhere in the hills of San Diego, this beautiful like freaking palace on this lot.
Yeah.
And it's like, who's sitting there? We've got like Travis Mash, it was Christmas Abbott, it was Michael Cashew, Brian McKenzie, Adee Zucker. It was like powerhouse. And it's like during the day you're doing these cool, you know, interactive you know, whether we're connecting and we're going through different exercises and talking about business or hot seats or all these things to like really learn and grow and progress. And then afterwards we're going and we're like hanging out in the hot tub and having, you know, parties.
That's where the real
night.
Mastermind was happening.
Well, that's what you make. You're making sure. Friends with people. You're hanging out with people. You're not just like sitting in a room together like, oh, what do you got on your notes? You're interacting all day. We're going and we're doing fun excursions, whether we're going hiking or ATVing or freaking kayaking or whatever. But then you're coming back. We're hanging out the hot tub late night. And, you know, people were up, I mean, having conversations with Kenny Kane till like 4 a.m, just having a good time. It was killer.
Yeah. Yeah.
Totally different from any other experience I've had where people were like, this is a mastermind. That was not a mastermind. That was a mastermind.
Yeah. And we actually are very careful about and have improved it over time. I mean, what was that, 2 years ago or year and a half ago?
Over 2 years ago, man.
Yeah. And so over time, we've even figured out how to make improvements every time. Every single mastermind is different than the previous. Everyone has a theme. You know, it's 3 days long, and we figured out what is day one, what does that formula look like, and how do we plug in these different components that is going to elicit the best result for people? What's going to allow people to really open up their creative mind and think differently? And day one is all about connecting with other people and getting people to a place where you create enough novel experience where they do disconnect from their daily life and they're able to really connect with new ideas and new people. And then by the time we're in the middle of day two, the mind is completely cracked open and things are just flowing. And then day three, you know, by the end of that, we've all dug into your business and you've helped dig into other people's business, find the opportunities, find the threats, and really walk away with, you know, you only need to walk away with two or three actionable items, because usually those two or three like highly effective actionable items that you're gonna go home with, you do those two or three things and it's gonna make a huge improvement in your business and in your personal life too. But I know that if you wanted a dozen, you're going to walk out with a dozen by the end of the third day. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we always cap the third day with a huge party because it's time to celebrate. Now, everyone that walks away from one of these retreats, you know, within a month or two is just like, wow.
Yeah.
Everything that I took what I learned there and I took action. And by the way, we don't really attract people to the mastermind that aren't action takers. So it's a real pleasure for me to have people in the room where it's like, oh, when this person gets this advice, I trust they're going to go home and they're going to execute. And that's usually when I'm on the phone with somebody and I'm talking to them and figuring out if they're going to be a good fit is, oh, there's an action taker. We know that if we plug them in, they're going to walk away with an awesome result. And that's great for me to have, like just to feel fulfilled in what we're doing.
Yeah, I know after the Cabo Mastermind, which was another killer mastermind that we did. That one kind of sucked. That all-inclusive resort was awful. I still have a stomach ache from all the tostadas that I ate.
Tostadas.
First of all, if you want to see Doug smile bigger than any other time, all you can eat ahi and guacamole tostadas poolside in a tropical resort. He literally was just shoveling them all day.
You just walk in and go, tostada, and they're just like, yep, yes, sir.
How many do you want? You're like, I don't know, four?
Six?
Five? Yeah.
How definitely many got? Gained some weight in that mastermind.
Oh, it's great. But yeah, I remember you're talking about action takers, people that are, you know, they have a very high speed of implementation. We had a couple people off that mastermind where really the best advice that the group during their hot seat could give to them, a hot seat's like where you ask the group, hey, I have this challenge or this opportunity in my business, and the whole group helps you solve that particular challenge. And for one or two people, really the best answer was, I think you just need to let your business partner go, or you know, something big, high level like that, which is, you know, not an easy thing to do for somebody, for anyone to do, really. And those people came back like within days, and they were like, "We let him go. He's gone. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for like pushing me to do the hard thing and to make the hard decision." So it wasn't like, "Oh, my Facebook ads aren't performing very well. Like, how do I get another 10% conversion and get like five more people in the door each month?" Like that's low level decision making. It's stuff you need to do in your company. Like that stuff's important. You got to do it. Great. But like the big high level stuff, like who your business partners are going to be and like how are you going to structure, you know, your entire strategy for the next like 1 year, 3 years, 5 years. Like the big high level stuff is really the stuff that we're working on at the mastermind. Not so much the small tactical stuff, but we can still talk about some of that too if you have specific questions.
Yeah, I mean, people do show up and there's the little, you know, side strategy, side tactic conversations going on. We might be at breakfast. It's like, oh, what do you do for Facebook ads? Oh, yeah, I'll get that. But yeah, the bulk of the meat of what's happening is very big picture decision making, things that are going to set you up for success 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years down the road.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this isn't the kind of event where you think like, oh, I'm going to go to a workshop and I'm going to get some new tactics going to serve me for the next 3 to 6 months. This is about like I said, about becoming a better business owner, becoming a better leader, a better person.
For sure.
These are the things that are going to apply to you, not just in the short term, but this is 3 years, 5 years, 10 years. I mean, the things that I take away from each one of these are things that affect my personal relationships, my, you know, with my wife, my kids, my businesses, everything, because this is about me becoming better.
Yeah.
And that carries on forever. Mm-hmm. And that means the next time I'm going to go, I'm going to learn something on another higher level. And you're going to continue to progress on a completely different plane rather than just, oh, what, you know, how is this going to affect my business in 3 months or 6 months? Is it worth it? It's like, dude, you are a better person. You are going to show up better as an employer, as a dad, as a who knows what. It's going to serve you in all different categories. That's probably one of the biggest takeaways from the people that we've had attend, is that they make massive shifts in their life permanently, like from there on out, where people are oftentimes on a very personal level, because it gets exposed. If you're in a room full of entrepreneurs, which are basically, you know, a successful entrepreneur is someone who's done a lot of like personal development. That's really what it always comes down to. Like, that's why you hear people get into all this stuff, is because that's really how you get better. It's not about the tactical shit that you learn.
Well, the business exposes, it's a reflection of yourself.
Right. And so when you get up in front of a room of a bunch of A players and you like lay your problem out in front of them, and all of a sudden 5 minutes in, they're just like, I think you're afraid of this or that. And you're like, shit. You're going to progress as a person because they're unraveling like the real reason, not the superficial tactical flaw that you had or whatever it is. And that stuff carries over into everything that you do. That's permanently evolving you.
Mm-hmm. No doubt.
These are some of my favorite events because they're either invite only, where we're just telling our friends like, hey, you got to come to this mastermind, and we're personally inviting you, or it's application only, which means we have very tight control over who's actually attending and who's showing up. We do not let just anyone into these programs. Like, you have to have some level of success. And then more important than that, you have to have the right mindset. You have to be the right kind of person. You have to be very willing to teach what you know and very kind of in an ego-less way, be very accepting of other people teaching things to you. Like, if you just feel like you know it all, you don't have an abundance mindset, you're kind of a jerk, like all those things, like, this is not the event for you. Everyone that comes to these events, they have an abundance mentality. They're super friendly. They're very willing to teach. Like, they don't think they know it all. Like these are the people that we want at these events. And that's why I generally enjoy hanging out at the mastermind, is because everyone there, they're just fucking rock star cool people. And I just want to hang out with those type of people.
Yeah. Nobody there thinks they just have it all figured out. Mm-hmm. We've run into a lot of people in business that, you know, they walk around like they've got it all figured out, not coming to the mastermind.
Yeah, it's and on the opposite end, you know, some people think they're like, oh, well, I've got to get like crazy successful. I've got to be making $1 million a year to go to this kind of event. That's not true either. We've had plenty of people who come who are more on the kind of front end of their entrepreneurial journey, but they have the right attitude. They're coming
the
into this
matters,
to make a bigger impact. They're passionate about you know about disrupting, you know, something that's broken or something that, that needs to progress. Mm-hmm. Those are the people who need to show up. So don't think that this is like, oh, well, I've got to be making, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars every month to be able to go to this thing. No, if you have your shit together and you're great at something and you want to contribute and you want to make a change, apply. Because I think then you'd be surprised, you know, because once we get on a call and we really get to know each other, we can usually suss out pretty quickly if someone's a good fit or not.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, money is a great way to tell, you know, to measure, you know, a little bit of business success to a degree. But what we're really looking for is somebody who is looking to make the big impact. It's why they're doing it. It doesn't have nearly as much to do with how much money people are making. It's more about what impact are you having on the world.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we can tell if someone's on their way up. We're like, okay, this person gets it. Like, maybe they haven't arrived yet, so to speak. But you can tell they got the right mindset. They got the right attitude. They have the right personality. They have the right skill set. They're learning every day and they're pushing, which is why they're applying to events like this in the first place, because they're trying to be the best person and the best business owner that they can possibly be. We can see when that person is on the ascent. Like, they are climbing the mountain, and even if they, you know, aren't, you know, the wealthiest person in the group, it doesn't matter. Like, we can tell that person is on their way up and they're going to do some big things, and we want to help that person get to where we think that they can go, and maybe even beyond where we or they think they can go.
Yeah, no doubt.
And just for the record, I'm going to say it, and if you don't like to have fun, don't apply either, because it's we have these are so much fun when we go on these retreats. For me personally, I mean, we do these every quarter, roughly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it is literally the high, like, as soon as one's done, I'm like, okay, I'm ready for the next one. Mm-hmm. And everyone who comes to repeat events says the same thing. They're like, this is not just, you know, I'm coming for personal development and to grow as an entrepreneur, but like, this is a vacation at the same time. We always go to a beautiful place. We eat great food. We're having a ton of fun. We're doing whatever fun stuff is available to us, whether that's, you know, because of where we are from, like, the, you know, we're in Mexico, so we're going to go out and snorkel, and we're going to go kayak, and we're going to go ATV and that sort of thing.
Or actually, ATV trip was fucking legit. That was really fun.
I want to throw out a challenge. I actually, and maybe you guys could confirm this, but I think I know how to have more fun than anybody. And my goal is always to see if I can just blow people's minds with how much fun we have at the retreat. So if you're somebody who thinks you can have more fun than me, come show me. Yeah. Come show me up. I want to see this.
Yeah, I dare you.
Apply for the event and then apply to work with us, and you can be on Mike's team, trying to make the event as fun as possible.
That's right.
Yeah, the ATV trip, I think, was one of my favorites out of all the cool stuff that we've done. Like, I like the basic stuff of you know, going hiking and you know, working out together and whatnot. But mm-hmm. Whenever we go, like, do something like ATV or kayak in the ocean that one time, which was really super cool. Like,
except for my kayak indoor. Sank on the way there.
That was your fault. Right. That was your fault.
I missed the indoor skydiving. I was so bummed when you guys were in Hollywood and I couldn't make it.
Indoor
skydiving. I didn't get to do it. I've always wanted to do indoor skydiving.
That was pretty cool.
It sounds really cool. I've done regular skydiving, which is also very cool.
Yeah. Almost as good as the indoor.
I'm so much more comfortable once I'm out of the plane actually skydiving than like the ride up. I'm like nervous on the ride up, and then I'm just like, oh, thank God.
Finally, get out of this thing.
Yeah, I don't like being in the airplane. Something about the turbulence.
And for those who are wondering, because I get this question a lot when we're talking to people who are, you know, going through the application process, you know, what's included with the actual, like, retreat? It's for people who are attending their first retreat with us, basically, you get yourself there, and we have, you know, we're always staying in a resort, and we are able to provide, like, discounts on the rooms, and there's packages, and sometimes we'll, like, bunk people up together if they want to do that to, you know, whatever. But it includes all the food, all the excursions, basically everything that's happened between Monday night and, Friday morning. That means the party, the getting to and from. Basically, just show up with your bags ready to go, and we have our coordinator, Ashley, who gets you all dialed in with the rooms and all that sort of thing. But it includes pretty much everything aside from getting your butt there and you know, your room. So
yeah, and then other than that, we want to make sure that we create an experience, and the way we can ensure that we do that is that we're taking care of everything. What I don't like, and I've seen this happen at different events, is, all right, we're gonna meet. All right, everyone, go get lunch on your own or whatever. Mm-hmm. We don't really do that. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It's all together. We're spending a lot of time. It's very focused and very intentional every step of the way.
Yeah, very much.
Yeah, the events where people kind of scatter, you know, where there's some people staying at one resort, some people staying at another resort because they're trying to find a deal on a room or something like that. And, you know, after if you had a workshop or whatever, like they're like, okay, session's over for today, like, you know, we'll see y'all tomorrow, and then like maybe you see some people at the bar that evening, that type of thing. Like, mm-hmm. you don't really connect with those people. It's really hard to make friends in those environments. So we try to do our best to make sure that everyone's staying at either in the same house or at the same resort, and we're doing everything together as a group. That way you have the ability to get to connect with people in a much stronger way than you would if you were just doing like the classroom setup where at dinner it's not supposed to be together. You're doing everything on your own. We do everything together. That way you can make those friendships really, really stick.
Yeah.
Makes a big difference.
Yeah. So if you're a leader in the industry or you're an up-and-coming leader in the industry, please apply. Go to barbellmastermind.com. Click the application button. That way we can get on the phone, have a conversation about what it is that you'd like to get out of the mastermind, what you can contribute. And I look forward to talking to you.